Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is NG News with the latest updates from the Angular community every week. The decision about the future testing framework has been made. It's going to be Vitest. Starting from Angular 21, the default test runner is going to be Vitest. That means if you run NG New, then Vitest will be the default value and not Jasmine. The best thing about Vitest, though, is not Vitest. For more than 2 years, we didn't really know, especially for new projects, which testing framework we should use. There was the official Jasmine Karma combination, whereas it was always said that Jasmine will be supported, but Karma not. And for Karma, a potential replacement would have been Modern Web Test Runner. As a second framework, it was in the beginning Jest only, but over time, we saw that Vitest also became a potential candidate. So what should you now do? Should you stick to Jasmine and wait that Karma is being replaced with the Modern Web Test Runner? Or do you want to bet on Jest Vitest very early, because integration was available via community contributions, but still you don't know which one is going to make it? And that's exactly the reason why just having a decision, regardless of the actual testing framework, is already a big relief for the majority of us. Vitest was the right decision. From the Angular team perspective, it was crucial that the new testing framework also supports running tests in the browser, which is exactly what Jasmine and Karma was doing. Jest was traditionally known to be executed on Node.js. They were using a browser emulation like JS DOM. On the other side, Vitest provides a browser mode where it executes the tests exactly as Jasmine Karma, and Vitest's browser mode became stable with Vitest version 4, which was released last week. So that was probably the deciding factor. Apart from that, Vitest has a huge community. It is used in almost all other front-end frameworks. It doesn't have any issues with ESM, unlike Jest. And it is built with TypeScript as first-class citizen. It also brings Angular closer to the big JavaScript ecosystem, where Vite is the standard and Vitest, as the name suggests, runs on top of Vite. Alex Rickabaugh, tech lead of the Angular framework, published an issue where he lists all problems that Angular has when it comes to content projection, especially based on its design. At the moment, it is still a list with links to other issues and their explanation, but not offering or suggesting a solution. This might indicate that we can expect that certain things might happen in that field as well. And that's it. I wish you a nice week. See you in the next episode. Goodbye.